Hello everyone, how are you? I hope you all will be fine and safe. Children, today I will explain a new chapter, that is collection of data. But before starting this, I will revise some important previous topic. Okay, so some important terms like investigator. So children, investigator is a person who conduct the statistical inquiry. Second, enumerator. Enumerator is a person who actually collects the data for investigation from the field of inquiry. Third, respondent is a person from whom data is collected, one who responds to the inquiry. Next, statistical inquiry is an investigation on a topic by any agency wherein relevant question quantitative information is collected. Next, survey. Survey is a method of gathering information from individuals on a topic. It is conducted by asking questions about a topic from a selected group of people. Next important topic is sources of data. It has two types. First, primary data and secondary data. So children, according to primary data, it which is originally collected by an investigator or agency for the first time for some specific purpose directly from the field of inquiry. But secondary data, which has already been collected and processed by some agency other than the investigator for a different purpose. Second difference is primary data is more accurate and reliable as it is the original data collected by the investigator himself or for a specific purpose. It requires more time and efforts for data collection. It is more costly as more number of enumerator are required to collect the data. It is raw data on which statistical tools need to be applied. For example, census data collected by the government. So, according to secondary data, data is less reliable as it has been collected by someone else for a different purpose or is second-hand data. It requires less time and efforts as data is already available. It is less costly as it is taken from a published or unpublished data sources. It is finished and processed data. Example is data published in economic survey. So children, we are using different types of method for preparing primary data collection. First method is direct personal investigation. It is also called direct personal interview. Under this method, the investigator collects data by having a direct face-to-face interview with the respondent. The investigator goes to the field personally and conduct an on-the-spot inquiry. Suitability, when the area of investigation is not very large and when maximum degree of accuracy is required. Second method is telephonic interview. Under this method, data is collected by the investigator through an interview with the respondent over the telephone. Suitability in case the respondent is reluctant to answer certain questions in a face-to-face interview and data is to be collected in a short period of time. Next method is mail questionnaire, also called mail interview. Under this method, the investigator makes a questionnaire pertaining to the field of investigation, which is sent to the respondent along with a covering letter specifying the purpose of the inquiry and a request to complete and return the same by a given data. The respondent are also assured of accuracy of the information provided by them. A stamped self-address envelope is also enclosed for returning the questionnaire by post. Suitability, when the area of investigation is large and the respondents are literate. That time this method will be used. Next method is pre-testing of the questionnaire. Children, next important topic is sources of secondary data. It has two types. First, published sources and unpublished sources. First, published sources include official government publications, semi-government publications, report of committees and commissions like pay commission report, education commission report, etc. Publications of research institutions. Next, international publications and newspapers and magazines. Next, unpublished sources includes unpublished statistical material maintained by research scholars, private investigation agencies, hospitals, administration, school administration and private firm, etc. But children, some limitations by facing by the government of secondary data, like one may not be sure of the method or procedure adopted for collecting the data. It may be influenced by the personal bias of the investigator. It may lack accuracy as data was collected for a different purpose. The data may be outdated or may not cover the full period of investigation. So children, in secondary data, these are the limitations which are facing by the government of India. So children, now I am explaining the new concept, that is census and sample methods of collection of data. So first is census method. According, it is a method of collecting data where data is collected from each and every element of the population or universe and there is 100% enumeration. It is more reliable and accurate since there is 100% enumeration. It is more costly and time consuming. It requires more number of enumerator. It is difficult to verify or cross-check the data. May not be possible to verify in case of large amount of data. Example, data collected by Census of India. Next, sampling method. It is a method of collecting data where only some representative items of the population, part of the universe or population are selected for the study. It is less reliable and less accurate since only part of the universe is taken into account. It is less costly and less time consuming. It requires less number of enumerator. It is easier to verify or cross-check since it involves less data. So, example of sampling method is sampling data collected by NSSO. So children, census method is that method in which data are collected covering every item of the universe or population relating to the problem under investigation. Next, sample method. Sample method is that method in which data is collected about the sample on a group of items taken from the population for examination and conclusion are drawn on their basis. Sample method is widely used in our day-to-day life. A lady in the kitchen, for example, tests only a grain or two of the rice to know whether the rice is boiled or not. By examining only a few drops of blood, a doctor determines the blood group of a person. So, these are the examples of sample method. Children, next topic is methods of sampling. It has many types. Method of sampling have two types. First, random sampling. It is already has two types. First, lottery method. Second is tables of random numbers. Non-random sampling have five types. First, purposive sampling, stratified sampling, systematic sampling, quota sampling and convenience sampling. So according this, first random sampling. Random sampling is that method of sampling in which each and every item of the universe has equal chance of being selected in the sample. In other words, there is an equal probability for every item of the universe being selected in the sample. Next is lottery method. Children, in this method, paper slips are made for each item of the universe. These slips are shuffled in a box. Then, impartially, some of the slips are drawn to form a sample of the universe. Second, tables of random numbers. Some statistician have prepared a set of tables called tables of random numbers. In this method, all items of the universe are first arranged in an order. Then using Tippett's table, the required number of items are selected as are needed for a sample. Next topic is non-random sampling. Non-random sampling includes all those methods of sampling in which all the units of population do not have equal probability. First, purposive sampling. Children, according this sampling is that method in which the investigator himself makes the choice of the sample items which in his opinion are the best representative of the universe. Next, mixed sampling. It is also called mixed sampling. Stratified or also called mixed sampling. Under this method of sampling, population is divided into different strata having different characteristics, and some of the items are selected from each strata so that the entire population gets represented. Next is systematic sampling. According to this method, units of the population are numerically, geographically, and alphabetically arranged. Every item of the numbered items is selected as a sample item. Next is quota sampling. According this method, the population is divided into different groups or classes according to different characteristics of the population. And last method is convenience sampling method. In this method, sampling is done by the investigator in such a manner that should his convenience. Like example, an investigator may select a sample of teachers merely by referring to the college's prospectus. This method is the simplest and least expensive, but unscientific and unreliable. It depends too much on the whims of enumerators. So children, today I have explained these topics from the chapter 3, collection of data. Important terms like investigator, enumerator, respondent, statistical inquiry, survey, sources of data. It has two types, primary data and secondary data. Methods of primary data collection by three methods: direct personal investigation, telephonic interview, mail questionnaire method. Sources of secondary data, it has two types, first published data and unpublished sources. Published sources includes government and non-government organization. Unpublished sources means private or individual firms has included. Limitations of secondary data. Primary data collection technique, census and sampling method, also I have explained in this chapter. Merits of census method, demerits of census method, merits of sampling method, and demerits of census method. Types of sampling method, it has two types, random sampling and non-random sampling. Random sampling also have two types, first lottery method and second is tables of random numbers. Non-random sampling have five types, first purposive sampling, second stratified sampling, systematic sampling, quota sampling and convention sampling. So children, I hope these concepts will be clear. So prepare these notes in your notebook and do the work properly. So take care. Goodbye.